So you want to be a doctor, which means you have to take the MCAT. But what is the MCAT? What is on it? How does it work? Let's dig in. MCAT stands for a medical college admission test, which is kind of like an SAT for getting into medical school. It has four sections, starting with the chemical and physical foundations of biological system, or CP for Chem Phys. This is your first natural science section, followed by section two, which is critical analysis and reasoning skills, or CARS for short. Just think of this as verbal comprehension. Section three is biological and biochemical foundations of living systems, or BB for bio-biochem. This is your second natural science section, followed by section four, the psychological, social, and biological foundations of behavior, or PS for psych-soc. This section is kind of like CARS with psychology and sociology terms mixed in. But I'm jumping ahead of myself, so let's back it up with a breakdown of exactly what's on each section. I cover the exact timeline, topics, sections, scores, and more on my website linked below or at layerforsci.com/aboutmcat. The Chem Phys section is 95 minutes long. That's 1 hour and 35 minutes to complete 59 questions, broken up as 15 discretes and 10 passages with about 4 to 7 questions each, which is about 8 minutes per passage. This section is broken down as 30% general chemistry, 25% biochemistry, 25% physics, 15% organic chemistry, and 5% biology. The CARS section is 90 minutes or an hour and a half long, with a total of 9 passages, which comes to 10 minutes per passage. You do not need any outside knowledge for this section. The bio-biochem section, like Chem Phys, is 95 minutes long, which is an hour and 35 minutes, for a total of 59 questions, broken up as 15 discretes and 10 passages. Again, about 8 minutes per passage. This section tests you on 65% biology, 25% biochemistry, 5% each general and organic chemistry. And finally, the psych-soc, like the previous sciences, is 95 minutes long, or an hour and 35 minutes, with a total of 59 questions, broken up as 15 discretes and 10 passages. This again comes to about 8 minutes per passage. This section tests you on 65% psychology, 30% sociology, and once again, biology at 5%. If you noticed, biology shows up in every science section. Now that we know what's on the exam, what does test day look like? And more importantly, if you add up the times, that comes to over 6 hours, but I call it a 7.5 hour exam. So let's break it down. Once you get started, you have 8 minutes to complete an examinee agreement. This is the same agreement that you signed when you registered, but once again, they want you to confirm that you have read and understand the rules. Then you have a 10-minute optional tutorial, which you can skip, but I don't advise it. Use this time to calm yourself down, to do some deep breathing, some relaxing meditations, whatever it takes to get yourself into the mindset of the exam. You don't need the tutorial because if you've been practicing under realistic conditions, you already know what to expect. And now you get to start the exam with the Chem Phys section at 95 minutes, followed by a 10-minute break, the CARS section at 90 minutes, followed by a 30-minute lunch break, the bio-biochem section, 95 minutes, followed by a 10-minute break, and the psych-soc section at 95 minutes. Is that it? Actually, no. You still have 5 minutes for the void question. That's 5 minutes to decide, do I want to score this exam and have medical school see it? Or do I think today was a wash, void the exam, and let's pretend it never happened? And finally, a 5-minute satisfaction survey letting them know how you felt about the testing conditions. Now that you know what's on the MCAT, how do you actually start? And more importantly, how do you start the right way? This is exactly where my How to Start Studying for the MCAT guide comes in. And you can find that at the link below or by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/MCATstart. Again, that's layerforsci.com/MCATstart.